NBC News intelligence and national security reporter Ken Dilanian, part of the team that broke this news. So, Ken, again, separate out for us. We have the Internet Research Agency. There's the social media disruption campaign, right, but that did not include WikiLeaks, the Podesta, and DNC hacks. What this is about is just that, Podesta and the DNC hacks.
That's exactly right, Chuck. We're told that Special Counsel Robert Mueller is moving toward an indictment or multiple indictments that would serve the same purpose as that document filed last month. Essentially, as you recall, that document left out the hacks of the DNC, the leaking operation, which played a significant role in the election, was a big part of the Russian meddling. So these new charges would tell the story of how that happened and name the Russians who were involved, allegedly. And they would rely, we are told, heavily on secret intelligence provided to Mueller by the CIA, the National Security Agency, DHS. Potential charges include conspiracy, violations of election law, violations of the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, which is the anti-hacking statute. Now, you pointed out some of the big unanswered questions here. One of them is, will this indictment or potential indictment name Vladimir Putin? Because we've already reported the U.S. has intelligence suggesting that Putin ordered and supervised this operation. But that's really sensitive intelligence. It's unclear whether the government would be willing to put that in a court document. Another question is, will they charge Russian government intelligence officials who supervised these freelance hackers who allegedly carried out this operation? Another huge question is the role of WikiLeaks. Obviously, the bulk of these leaked emails came through WikiLeaks, and the CIA director, Mike Pompeo, has accused WikiLeaks of being essentially a hostile non-state intelligence service, an arm of the Russian government in this instance. But WikiLeaks will come back and claim they had acted as journalists. That could pose a problem for a potential prosecution. So unknown whether they will be named in these potential charges. But it's clear that the Mueller investigation is picking up steam, and this would be another big shoe to drop in terms of laying out how this case happened, Chuck.
Let me go to the WikiLeaks point here. Is it possible that he goes with individuals, because the entity, it may be a journalistic organization, but the individuals in it, is that more likely where he would go? So Julian Assange, the individual, or other individuals involved?
I think that's a possibility, because even as journalists, we're not protected from trafficking in stolen material or knowingly subordinating, you know, stealing or hacking to do our journalism. We're not allowed to do that. So, yes, in theory, individuals could be charged in that manner, Chuck.
Is there any, I guess there's always a chance this is a sealed indictment where we, because of the sensitivity to the intelligence, but boy, a secret indictment by Mueller, boy, that it seems like in this environment that I'm guessing that's something he'd like to avoid.
Well, the argument for doing a sealed indictment, some of my sources are telling me, is if you want to catch some of these Russians unaware, traveling to a third country, and actually snatch them up and bring them back for trial. But the argument against that, as we saw with this last indictment, Mueller seemed really to want to tell the American people the story of how the Russians carried out this election meddling, because we're not getting that from the rest of the government. And a lot of times it's based on very secret intelligence. This would be sort of part two of the story of how the Russians did it. And it would also send a message to the Russians, you know, we know a lot about how this worked, and we know how to potentially stop it from happening again.
All right, Ken Dilanian, trying to untangle.